Just going up to scrub.
See you there. Is that Ward 3?
Yeah, just wanted to get it signed off before we go into theatre.
Good call.
So, Chris has briefed you on the anaesthetist's concerns?
No, not yet.
Graham's worried about the patient's LVF.
I heard there was a cardiovascular problem.
Don't want his heart to stop once we've knocked him out. So we started him on blood pressure meds.
And no doubt Graham will want him in and out of there as quickly as possible.
Exactly.
Which Chris won't like.
Right again. Hope your hubby knows what he's doing.
Of course.
You know, Graham's a conservative from way back. Wouldn't be the first time they've knocked heads.
Chris knows exactly what he's let himself in for.
He's turning into a bit of a risk junkie, if you ask me. Long run of tricky ops.
Well, he'd never do anything dangerous, if that's what you're saying.
Yeah, well, I'm just not looking forward to this one, okay? Right, I'll get this set up and see you in theatre, okay?
Yeah.
Your best, worst horror movie ever. Go on.
Hey, Bex, can you grab me a pillow?
I've got a bone to pick with you.
Haven't you guys got anything better to do?
Hey, it was just a joke. Bex! Oh. Okay, so that totally sucked.
Well, if at first you don't succeed.
Maybe we should just let him come around in his own time.
Or maybe we should just keep going until he can't help but laugh.
Go, little Miss Corporate.
Sorry?
Sharp threads. I thought you might have slipped into one of your AC numbers.
Business meeting, Dylan, means business clothes.
That means come and pop up.
Would you like a drink?
I'll have what you're having.
Sure. Monique, can we have another one here, please? Sure. Thank you. Okay, so this is what I've got so far, but my main concern is packaging costs. See, I can't seem to find a way to reduce it any further.
You've done heaps.
There's a lot more I can do.
None of which is urgent right now. Yeah, drop by the office tomorrow. We'll talk about it then.
I can't drop by the office tomorrow. Sale of this place is cranking along, so my time is pretty tight.
How is the other half coping with the long hours?
Let's just say my other half isn't particularly business-minded.
Yeah, tell me about it.
They don't get the thrill of the chase like I do.
Cheers.
Would you like to take this home with you? Or I could email you a copy later.
No, we'll do it now. Unit prices, eh?
Yeah, it's just ballooned on me.
Come on.
More obstruction?
Yeah. I'll try through the right iliac fossa. Damn.
You want to try a smaller trucker?
I doubt it'll help, to be honest. It feels like there are adhesions everywhere. Okay, I'm going to switch to an open-collar cystectomy instead.
Which you know isn't my preferred option.
Nor mine, but needs must.
If we convert to open surgery, the table time is far longer than
is either. Is the patient showing any
not
signs
yet,
of stress?
No.
Excellent.
But another hour of surgery would be too risky.
Well, then we'll move as fast as we can.
I know this is your latest party trick, Warner, but you don't call the shots here, remember? Patient welfare is my territory.
You told me the guy's stable. I told you I'll work quickly, so let's get a move on, eh?
You sure we should proceed, Chris?
We are proceeding. If everyone could pull finger, please. Brenda.
Gotcha.
Thank you. Tony, prep the patient.
If Sarah gets wind of this...
She's on a dinner break.
Yeah, but you know who she'll dump on me.
Ah, you love it. Anyway, she won't be back for ages. Trust me.
Yeah, but it's not going to be a good look if she comes back early and finds us mucking around.
What is this, wimp out day or something? Am I the only one who wants to get back to laughing?
That's a pretty good gag.
Pretty good. It's a total crack-up. Crack up the left femur. Nasty fracture. I'll write up the notes, eh?
You want to look up?
Hey, baby.
Hey. Hey, Bex, Chipper here took a bit of a hit. Got his hand. Do you reckon you could take a look?
Sure. Hey, Jippo. Got yourself into a bit of strife, right?
Don't
know. Let's take a look.
Sucked in badly.
Is this supposed to be funny or something?
Your face, yeah.
How lame can you get?
Oh, come on, bro.
Excuse me.
Okay, now not 1 cent off your unit price.
1 cent? Is that going to make a difference? Okay.
Now, project that figure annually and you've got...
Look at that. That's heaps less.
Let me guess, you forgot you were dealing with such large sums.
1 cent would have meant diddly squat on the kind of budgets I usually do.
But when we're dealing with seven figures...
You're amazing.
And you're hot. You should see yourself. Your whole face lights up. It's like this enthusiasm's burning off you.
Well, I must admit, that's a big relief to be able to talk to someone who finally knows what I'm on about.
Don't you talk to your husband about work?
Well, it's just, you know, we don't work in the same field.
What does he do?
Medicine.
Flash.
Where is that pencil? Because I need to write this in.
Same with mine. You know, it's like you come home after this hard-out day. You're totally fired up because you've nailed a pitch, or you've just signed a huge contract. You come home and it's like, tell me later, this is my favourite programme, or you forgot to put out the recycling.
Yeah, and sometimes you start to feel like you're this tiny cheerleader in a weenie corner and you're saying, yay me, but no one's listening.
I am. That's why seeing your smile, feeling that buzz. I totally get it.
I know you do.
Kindred spirits.
Solo cheerleaders.
Like with the tiny bouncy skirts?
Shut up.
Okay, thank you, Brenda. Diathermy. How are we looking here? Good.
Wound drain?
Yeah, and some Vicryl. Let's close up the peritoneum.
Chris.
Yep. We've got some abnormal ventricular beats.
Damn.
Is an understatement. Draw up some noradrenaline.
BP's down to 95 on 50.
Happy now?
I'm closing up right now, and then we're out of here, okay? You suit your eye drain.
Oh, I can have it.
No, I've got it.
Bex, are you okay?
My mum is in hospital. I feel bad enough as it is without being made feel stupid, hassled.
Sorry.
Did the word insensitive ever cross your mind?
Look, me and Alice, we just thought that maybe...
No, you didn't think.
Well, you laugh at splatter movies, and we just thought maybe we could help cheer you up with a few pranks. Look, no way did we want to upset you or make things worse. It's just, it's so hard being around someone you care about and not being able to help them. I'm sorry, it wasn't the right thing.
I guess I have been a bit of a downer.
You have had a lot going on.
Hey. Thanks for trying, even if it was a pretty sick and twisted way to show me that you care.
Oi.
Maybe you could call Alice off, eh? You know, game over.
Sure.
Ta.
So you'll sort me out a discount then?
Hey?
On packaging. You're bound to have some connections somewhere, don't you? Pull a few little strings.
Here we go.
You're the one who whacked down my unit price.
So?
So, you're the one who can find a supplier who'll play ball.
Well, I know exactly what kind of ball you play. Hardball.
So that's a yes?
Mm-hmm. I'll see what I can do if you stay for one more drink.
Unfair tactics, Dylan.
Only playing hardball, Jay.
I thought that was my game.
Which two can play?
No, I'm ignoring your bargains and I'm heading home.
Well, you can't blame a guy for trying.
Get your hand off my butt.
Who, me?
Yes, now go home to your wife.
Yes, ma'am.
Pretty touch and go for a minute there.
Yeah. So pretty close to the windjaw, Chris.
Seems to be making a habit of it.
Oh, it's all these tricky ops, one after the other. It's the nature of the beast.
He's chased the tricky ops.
Yeah, he doesn't seem to feel, I don't know, satisfied unless he's pushing himself to the limit.
To the point where his judgment is compromised?
If you've got an issue with Chris's performance, you need to take it up with him.
Well, it's you in a tough position, though, isn't it?
Chris's decisions are his business.
Yeah, but they involve your staff. As nurse manager, don't you have to say something if a surgeon is putting patients at risk?
I doubt it'll come to that.
Do you? Husband or not, I'd talk to him sooner rather than later, for both your sakes.